to the clanging bell of your alarm clock and turned on the radio to hear glum old FDR once again preparing the nation for war. You made your way to the breakfast nook, where you tucked into a plate of bacon, eggs, and sugared grapefruit halves and washed it down with a cup of black coffee that took 20 minutes to percolate. While you ate, you thought about the long day ahead. Your toothpaste wasn't a paste at all. Instead, it was a powder that you sprinkled over your toothbrush whose bristles were trimmed boar whiskers. You put on something that looked a lot like this, and of course grabbed your hat, then walked out into the chilly morning to work. In the cab on the way to work, you heard the Ink Spot singing Maybe, and you thought about how much more convenient it would be if you had your own car to drive to the Hills Brothers Coffee Company. By 8:15, you were crunching the numbers from last month's sales sheets, worrying about a dip in sales of your most popular roast. For lunch, 25 cents got you a sliced ham and egg sandwich and a cup of black coffee at the counter of a luncheonette, where you read an article in the San Francisco Call Bulletin about the mysterious twist in the most recent episode of Lux Radio Theater and chatted with the waitress about whether Gone with the Wind really deserved to win 8 Oscars. You made $42.30 a week, sent 5 back home to Mom and your 4 younger brothers and sisters, then put 50 cents aside for a trip on an airplane someday. You hadn't seen a Charlie Chaplin movie since you were a teenager, but he was making a huge comeback in The Great Dictator, so when Danny, a mechanic from your building, asked if you wanted to go, you said swell. You changed your clothes and met Danny at 7 in front of the Globe, and laughed harder than you laughed all day as Chaplin brilliantly mocked Hitler. For dinner, you went to the Argentine Pavilion for an extravagant $2 steak, after which you politely refused Danny's advances. So you went to sleep and dreamt of Hitler and Chaplin and coffee beans and Danny.